So excited to be back here, be in this room, be with these boys, these super talented musicians. Oh, what a weekend we have planned, Robbie.
Yes, sir.
I know every week we say, oh, come Saturday night, it's so special. But this Saturday night, I mean, this is a standout Saturday night special.
And we always say that, but it's really true. Nashville, people come out from Nashville.
People want to be involved in the Saturday night special here in Music City, USA.
It's true.
It happens to be the birthplace of me.
Oh. Yeah. We should call it Nika.
Now you're talking. Now you're having ideas I can work with.
Well, like I said, there's no room for me and Nika.
Already we're making this part about you. You know what? Maybe we should call it the Not About You part. You know what I'm saying? Listen. Ladies and gentlemen, we can stand here in major all day, but, you know, we could, and we will backstage. But in the meantime, let's get this show started, shall we? So, two men were delightful on screen together, and equally delightful as individuals. We paired them together in really what is a dream team for any bachelorette party. Ladies and gentlemen,
casino hotel in North America. He's full of these really interesting trivial knowledge. much questions. Is that Richard? This being his hometown goal. But I'd never been to Nashville before. And I went out last night. I tried to bring David Haydn-Jones last night, and he's like, no, I'm in bed.
I'm nursing the cold.
I'm sick. I'm poorly. What's he doing?
So I went out on my own last night. I think there were a couple people that were out until 3 a.m. Where are you guys?
Yeah.
And someone drank two bottles of Jameson as well. Where? There you are. Speak on.
I'm a lightweight.
Yeah. I went to the stage and I walked in and they were singing Tennessee Whiskey as I walked in the door. So I was like, because I'm in the right place. And it was so much fun, I gotta tell you. But I'm excited to see some more of Nashville tonight, maybe. Or, well, we'll be here tonight.
We're working. We're karaoke. Who's going to karaoke?
It's a big stage. It's like a proper stage. It's like fire.
No.
Oh my
now,
God.
Wait a second. Is this the new Grand Ole Opry? Is that where we're in right now or not?
No.
Sorry. But there's an old Grand Ole Opry and a new Grand Ole Opry, is that right?
Yes.
How many Nashvillians are here?
Yeah, that's important.
What is it? Is it? That's not Nashvillian, obviously. What is it?
Nashville.
It is?
Yeah.
I'm so smart, despite myself. When it comes to trivial bullshit, yeah,
we believe that.
Okay, let's take some questions.
Question time.
Who's first? Oh, hello, young man.
Hi.
What's your name?
Jacob.
Jacob, are you from Nashville, Jacob?
No.
Okay. Me neither. You want to ask a question?
Yes.
Go ahead.
What is your favorite thing about your characters?
What was my favorite thing about my character? His redemption in the end was my favorite thing about my character. The fact that he,
rub it in.
Excuse you?
No.
Both characters.
I said, rub it in. Redemption.
Yeah.
Whoa. Are we doing this already? I didn't bring the siren. Sorry, carry on. Your favorite thing.
My favorite thing was when he kind of came, he was like a phoenix arising from the ashes and gone off with the boys in the end until has everyone seen the show? Is everyone up to date?
Yes.
I get shot in the face. I get shot in the head.
Yeah.
He did it. Unceremoniously, in the middle of a great speech, too. I was going to riff for another 3 pages, but they were like, Jones, can you just kill Malcolm? Yeah, shut him up. And he shot me in the back of the head. Sorry. Yourself.
Thanks, Edna. I think the favorite thing that I love everything about my character. This has been such an amazing gift as an actor to play. So complex, so much of a stretch for me, so many different elements that I get to play. Just soft, but you know. But I think what I'm really enjoying, particularly now, is this attempt that they're doing this season to really open up Ketch as someone who's trying to find redemption, who's trying to be his best human self despite having a long ledger of iffy.
In order to complete, it's like the 12-step program. In order to complete your final bit of redemption, you have to bring me back.
So maybe I'd find you in the AU, nicer, better version of you.
Yeah. What?
But, you know,
I think a bad version.
Someone who's actually good at their job.
Yeah, okay.
You mean me, Adam, or Mitch?
Adam's amazing at his job. Mitch was a big shot. But to your point, honestly, my favorite thing is the challenge and the complexity that the writers and the producers are allowing me to play. Hey, did anyone see last night's episode? Yeah. Taking a general audience poll here, Ketch getting close to redeemed or no?
Yeah.
And how about the nose? Okay. A little closer to 75%, maybe?
Yeah.
What else does he have to do?
Die.
Thank you.
I feel like I feel like I'm on the Price is Right right now. I'm like, I can't hear what you're saying.
Higher, lower.
Thank you for your question. Great question.
Good question, dude. Thanks, Jacob.
Should I go over here?
You gonna sing karaoke tonight, Jacob?
Yes.
Okay, awesome.
Hi.
Hi, David.
What's your name?
Hello, what is
that? Hi, Tammy. What's happening?
Good, how are you?
Hi, Pumpkin Haydn-Jones.
He's very scared and very nervous.
Go ahead. We're all family here.
What is that?
That is an avatar of my head. Oh, the strange things the internet will do.
It's like looking in a mirror.
So this question is actually for Pumpkin to you, because he's just too scared to say. So he's made up a bucket list of what he would like to do in his pumpkin life. So he would like to know what we might find on your bucket list.
Oh, bucket list.
I do like,
what did I hear?
Mary Winchester!
Say it again?
Mary Winchester!
Mary Winchester? Ooh, Chance is a stepdad. I dig it. I feel it.
What?
They would hate that. Oh my gosh, can you imagine? That should be a sitcom spinoff. Right? My assassin father. But then when John comes home, boy, he's like, what have you been doing in my absence? Bucket list. I want to... I want to learn how to ride a motorcycle. Because my mom, here's the thing, I had to have a double for Ketch's riding. For insurance reasons, but I...
Yeah, sure, insurance reasons. Yeah.
And also, I tell everyone to die. Yeah.
Aww, he's not recharged at all.
Do you ride a bike?
I told someone, I was meant to say it was a very interesting story, but it was my story, so I can't really say that. But my mom went to a fortune teller when I was young, and the fortune teller said, don't ever let your son ride a motorcycle. And then I ignored it, and then I rode a motorcycle, and I crashed into a car. I was like 18, and we went to Crete on holidays, me and all my mates, this is the main street here. And we're on the side street, the lady was riding me the moped, and she's like, okay, you've ridden one of these before? I was like, yeah, yeah, of course. Jumped on, my mate is standing beside her, and I went, and I went right out. And because in Ireland we drive on the other side of the road, I turned the wrong way up the road and drove right into a car. And I went underneath the car. But I was okay. The bike was not. The face on the woman, she just went. So concerned, was bundled over laughing. He was like, so no, I won't ride motorcycles.
Well, and you know, to your point, my mom had family members who didn't make it as a result of motorcycles. So that was like a very strong mom, you're not getting on a bike.
Absolutely.
My whole life. So
now you want to be disobedient.
Well, now it's just kind of this thing you just kind of want to have in your back pocket as an actor. You know what I mean? Like, you want to know how to ride a bike.
I want to travel more. I want to see like loads of different places that I haven't seen. I want to go down to like, I want to do the Aztec Trail. You're still allowed in that. I'm not even sure you're allowed in that anymore.
Aztec Trail.
Yeah. I don't know what that is. It's near the Inca Trail.
Oh, right now. the Inca Trail. By the Aztec Trail.
There's loads of stuff. That's a great question. I've never skydived. I'm scared shitless to do it, but I really want to do it. I'd love to think, do you know those wingsuit dudes?
Oh.
That would be awesome. I saw one once, it was a while ago, and this guy is going flying down this thing, and it doesn't make any sense how, like, there's cars driving up the road, and he just goes, whoosh. And this guy tried to high five him and stuff.
Dude, I saw those guys in 60 minutes. Like, if I was like, I knew my time was up, I'd be like, I'd start training For sure.
I think the life expectancy of the mortality rate of a wingsuit dude is like not very high.
Exactly. It's extremely dangerous.
We could be here all day talking about this. It's a good question.
How to kill ourselves.
I'll let you open a more definitive answer for our next call. Hello, my love. Oh, nice to meet you here.
And, my question is for both of you. First of all, all this good having with you, that's on my bucket list. Anyways, I'm curious what aspects of other characters you guys played that you missed playing a lot. Like, I don't know.
On different shows?
Yeah, like, Adam Fitzpatrick and whatnot, like, your other characters.
Yeah. I sort of got to Hollywood as a result of my sketch comedy stuff that I used to do. That was how I sort of entered into the business. I would love to do just sort of like broad, half-hour, fun sitcom again, because that's kind of was my track for a while. And then I sort of, you know, started getting other jobs and stuff like that. But yeah, I love about this show is that how much it does lean into little comedic moments and stuff like
your jobs.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I feel like I get to do a little sketch comedy of these things now. It's just kind of, you know, well, yeah, this is, yeah, here I am wearing chaps.
I think that's why it's a jean, right? He wasn't wearing the jeans. Woo!
No one wants to see that. But to your point, how did this just turn into Magic Mike 3? Karaoke.
Naked karaoke. Stephen, I'm so sorry. No, we won't be naked.
It's a family show.
Family show, everybody.
It's a family show.
You know, you mentioned Adam Fitzpatrick, and I love playing that guy. He was so screwed. This is the character I played in a TV show called Being Erica that was we shot in Toronto. And he was so messed up. I was privileged enough to have a really good mom and dad and sisters and stuff, and I had a great upbringing. This guy didn't, so I just think it's fun playing people that you've got to, you know, reach out to get, and like, you know, David is so unlike Ketch in real life, it's ridiculous, so it's just fun to mess around with that kind of stuff and see how dangerous and evil and stuff you can be, so I always want to play those kind of characters and that are unlike me as a person, because you get to be.
I want to play a character that doesn't sweat profusely. That would be nice. My cold is literally leaving my body on stage.
That's disgusting. Right now.
So, you're welcome, next guests. Do we have anything? I should just like Clorox wipe the stage for 10 minutes before anyone else comes out of here. Patient zero, David Haydn-Jones. Hi there. How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Thanks for wearing the shirt, thanks for getting it, I appreciate you.
Yeah, no problem. Thanks.
Less than three.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Jennifer.
Hi, Jennifer.
Hi, okay, wow, this is scarier than I expected.
What's wrong with you up here?
So, one thing I was kind of surprised by in season 12 was how easily the men of letters seemed to accept Mary being back. We have the scene of Kex like staring at the photo, but I don't know if that was him noticing she hadn't aged or just kind of being obsessive. and I love Kex, but that was a bit weird. So I was wondering if you guys thought that was something like a conversation that happened off state, like off screen.
Well, we didn't know her. We didn't know her.
But I mean, they would have known she died.
Not really. Because you see, us British men of letters didn't really care much for the American people. We were like, you know, they're over there, we're doing it right here, we're getting rid of all the werewolves. There aren't been anyone since 29, I believe. Was it 1929?
Yeah.
We got rid of those guys.
Sure. What did you say?
I was the bookkeeper.
Exactly. Get the time for you.
I don't think you cared. Well, I certainly didn't care.
We discussed this.
Love boots here.
I knew. But also, remember, Ketch had relationships with Rowena and Crowley.
It's just a pervert. Oh. Just friendships.
It always skews dirty with you, dude.
That's right.
You're such a dirty Irishman. I love it.
Yeah,
I just thought something. So, to your point, But you know what? In the supernatural world, it's kind of like we had this discussion. There's some fun episodes of like coming up for you, and we're all like, "Well, this is weird. What are all these people doing together?" And you're like, "These people have seen it all at a certain point. You know what I mean? Like they don't care. We were fighting monsters in the supernatural and ghosts and spirits and vampires and you know all that stuff. It's like it doesn't take much for you to go, oh, okay, that's." It's hard to be shocked in supernatural world, you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
You know?
Yeah.
When you shoot someone in the back of the head, that's shocking.
Well, it's pretty shocking.
It's shocking to everyone involved.
I'm still not over it, as you can tell.
Thanks, Jennifer.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jennifer. Hello.
Hi, I'm Leslie.
Hi, Leslie.
So my question is for David, but if you want to paint her, you can.
Please. No, Adam's used to be a secretary.
So my question is, since you're wearing chaps, how long are you gonna last on a bowl?
Oh. Is there a bowl here?
I mean, I'm sure we can make something happen for you.
Are you offering yourself as tribute?
Alright, cool. Let's do it.
Tribute, bowl, and karaoke.
Well, I don't show you on the stage. You might hurt yourself.
I'm not well. I'm dainty. I'll tell you what.
Well,
I will ride your karaoke tonight. We're running the rules. Hold on. This is good. This is a good challenge. I like it there. Excuse me. I'm dying.
I'm gonna throw you off.
I like Adair, but there are some ground rules. So, what do I get to hang on to? Is there one time? Do I get to throw a braided rope around you? And by the way, you know why bulls buck, don't you?
Yeah.
Who knows why? Know why bulls buck the way they do? Yeah. Should I do that to Mr. Fergus here? By the way, all those, I'm not going to say it, but all of those who know why bulls buck, you tell your neighbor right now why. I got the vapors just thinking about it. Where is my lip tumor? My lip trash.
Time's not accepted. Time's not accepted.
We're doing it real!
Well, we went through the photo ops.
Hey, anyone getting a photo op with me and Adam or me? Should I wear the chaps and the cowboy hat and the photo op? Because they are
chaps. I'll get the syrup around my knee. It's knee.
I feel like the hashtag for this convention is hashtag cowboy kink.
Yeah, I think that's cool.
7Ks.
Oh, here, I got a joke. What do you call a three-legged donkey?
What?
A walkie. What do you call a three-legged donkey with one eye?
What?
A winky monkey. What do you call a three-legged donkey with one eye from Nashville? A honky-tonky winky monkey.
State. I'm not feeling secure, but we'll go. sir.
No, you can go to town, baby.
How do you come?
Oh, we have a weapons expert in our midst.
Fantastic.
A Navy SEAL. She might be a SEAL, but she is the Navy.
I wish I could see y'all better.
How you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm not too bad.
Well, my question's for David, because frankly, I talked to you way too fucking long as you're looking. Just saying.
Alright. Thank you, guys. I love you.
Thanks for filling that for me, Adam. Bye.
So I'm into, like, really shitty movies. So Hallmark is really shitty.
Thanks. Next question mark? Sad face emoji? Yes.
So does that mean that you are going to be in 30 new Christmas movies playing a single dad?
I'm not going to be in all 30. I don't know if I'm going to make one this year. Although, apparently, in the world of Hallmark, I have perhaps a little cachet, and they're being nice to me over there. So, we'll see. The movie I did last year with Autumn Reese or Bramble House, did really well. Thank you. I'm always fascinated by the Venn diagram of how much Supernatural and Hallmark overlap. And it's kind of fascinating, actually. Like, it's actually more than you think it would be, which is interesting. And obviously, the people I play on Hallmark are like single, widowed dads.
Do you find love in the hand all the time?
I do find love. I know how to find love.
It's hard to stay away from love.
Hashtag Haydn-Jones. Cowboy King. But yeah, I'm not shooting 30. They're not all going to be David and Jones. I don't even know if there's going to be one of them, but they're super lovely people over there, and I have a great time shooting them, so if they ask me, I will certainly play.
When does your next one come out? I think I saw you on Instagram with What's Her Face from Waffle House.
Yeah, Joey Sweetin.
I love the Twitter phrase. She's Hallmark movies and What's Her Face.
Can we just call you?
What's Her Face?
This is Mrs. Damning with Faint Praise over here.
This is what happens when you're in the Navy.
So I think your work is actually poop, but like I really like watching it. There's no release date yet. I know that they're editing it right now, and the working title is Love Under the Rainbow.
Is there a leprechaun in it?
And unfortunately, no, it is not the first queer positive Hallmark movie, although I would love to be a part of that. Would that be an amazing thing to see if you got to that level? I think I'd love to see it. But it was super sweet, and Jody is awesome. She's a rock star. Like, she's a super cool person, and we had a lot of fun and a lot of chemistry. And yeah, so we'll see. So maybe you can add that to your poopy movie list. Thanks for your questions and your support. I appreciate it.
How's it going?
Hi. So my question is for both of you.
Where are you from?
North Carolina.
Oh, what delicious accents.
That's beautiful.
I got yours is pretty beautiful too.
I got family in North Carolina. I built a house there.
Really? Cool.
Just had to say that.
Yes.
I love North Carolina.
Carry on.
Okay, so if you could describe your characters with a song, what would it be?
With a song?
With a song.
I was going to
be shot in the hotel.
My baby shot me down. God, you've got Myers syndrome.
Better than Stockholm syndrome would be considered. Well, it might turn into Stockholm syndrome then on.
Ask Mary about that.
I didn't write it. I didn't make it up. I wasn't even playing around.
I kind of like, a little jazzy swing version of Mac the Knife, but Catch the Knife. When the black strap is up, that's his baby. Pow! Yeah, oh yeah, pow! Yeah. Perfect. Let's catch the knife.
We need a little fall like this, probably.
Good question.
Great question.
David, what part of North Carolina?
Do you know where New Bern and Aurora are?
That's near where I am.
Oh, fantastic. Yeah, just right up there.
Nice hair.
Thank you.
Wow, that's really shiny.
Hey, what's up?
The sky?
Yeah. That's a Jared joke. I've heard it used it. Relax.
So my question is for both of you. I wanted to know if you guys swapped bodies for a day, what would you do?
I would commit suicide.
So angry. I'm so loving and you're so angry. You would commit suicide. Wait, how does that even work?
It just sounded funny in my head on your set.
Does that mean you would still transport back to your body, or to your body?
In my mind, yes. But it seemed like an easy thing to say.
I would just drink and smoke and do all the drugs possible, because I just use and abuse this meat suit, and then come back to my fresh, steamy spa man suit.
Answer two.
That's teasing. Hey, you were the one who said you were going to commit suicide in me.
Yeah.
No. Wait a second, that's a weird sentence. I'm going to commit suicide in you.
With it, nothing wrong.
Ride the bull.
Thank you.
Are some of the people, are there more people who know why a bull buck, by the way, out there?
Yeah.
It's not for
some. It's not pleasant.
Hi there, what's your name?
Melina.
Hi, Melina.
So my question is, what song, for both of you, what song are you just currently obsessed with, just repeating, listening to 100 times in a row?
That's a great question.
But, like, we're in Nashville, we should know this.
So what's my earworm, like right now?
Yes.
Oh, this is going to sound so self-serving. A little song I wrote called Making Bacon. Does anybody know this from online from Rome last year?
Yeah. Yes.
I'm actually in the studio right now recording it. I have flushed it out. So I'm writing a song based on a joke from Rome last year. And we're making it because I love it there. Case in point.
Same.
Well, it's very simple. Making bacon.
Gotta
make that little bacon with as crispy as thin's for now.
Did you write it?
I have the whole versus chorus. It's being produced right now.
I don't know.
And it's a country song. And it's a hurtful country song, believe it or not. You're gonna see it. Follow me on social media, it will be released in a month, and you will laugh and make fun of me, and I'm okay with it.
I didn't find that song.
I think you guys are trying to kill me.
No.
This is my first con, so I'm freaking out right now.
Freak out? That's it. Why? Freak out?
You're fantastic. It's amazing. What's your song, Adam? Sing. What's your song?
I can't. Look, it's not that I can't get out of my head. You know what I have in my head all last week? Boom, 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 baby, and the kids.
Does anyone remember the Family Guy episode? Anyone remember Family Guy?
Yeah.
Do you remember the Bird is the Word episode?
Yeah. And I swear about the bird.
I was that, so I had that in my brain, S-U-not, for 6 months. And my wife was like, I will murder you. I will murder you. She should have called you.
She should have called me.
I will commit suicide inside you.
Oh, I love your wife.
I don't even know.
No, I have been getting Tennessee Whiskey has been in my head all night last night. And I, to be honest with you, at Rome last year, Jensen sang Tennessee Whiskey.
God, he's such a terrible singer.
Not, obviously. But the guy last night, I mean, in the stage bar, was singing, and it's just such an addictive song. And our very own Richard Spade Jr. told me that George, you'll be able to tell me what it's. Richard? And Chris Stapleton even sing it originally, but his version is amazing, and his version is
cool. Sing, I don't know what sing it for me.
I can't sing it.
Just do a little bit.
Yes, and listen to me. You see, sing it.
Everybody sing it. Your turn.
Here, listen.
Crowdsource it.
Okay,
while you're pulling that up, I'll take another question.
Here we go.
Sing it. Oh.
My question is actually for you, David, which is kind of convenient considering he's messing with his phone.
How would you, like, besides opposite of shooting, like, if you had a choice, Would you go out in Blazing Glory or Hans Gruber style?
Well, we both died.
Both died.
Once already. I would love Ketch to do a heroic death to complete his redemption. Guns blazing. I think that's the only way he's fully redeemed, right? He's gotta save the Winchesters at some point. Help save the world, and then be like, I'm sorry for my sins. Here I go. Boom.
Oh, well, as long as I'm part of your apology, that'd be great. One last question. This young man has been here the whole time. Hello, young man.
Hi.
It is a man. Yes, it is your man. Sorry, Elijah Bing. How are you?
Good.
What's your name?
Nate.
Hiya, Nate.
My question is actually directed to both of you.
Okay.
And how did you get your role on Supernatural?
I came to the party. I only ever auditioned for the one role, and I was away or something, and they got me down to the last three people, and they reached out and they said, I think I was just buffer. I think they brought me in to see if I could play the role, and I just went for it once, and met all the five people in the casting department and got cast. So it was pretty straightforward, my audition process. I only had one chance at it, and managed to be lucky enough to get it. Here I am. Good question.
Yeah. I auditioned too. I actually went in as a cockney biker originally, and then they said they wanted to change it to the more refined, received pronunciation, toffee nose, proper English.
And you're wearing chaps.
Exactly. I'm the British cowboy. But yeah, it was two callbacks in the first audition, and they sort of changed my character as I went along, and then boom, I got the call, and here we are with these amazing people. So.
Thanks so much. We'll catch up there. Thanks so much.
You're going to see both these gentlemen on this stage.